I've been lucky enough to build a bunch of really cool mechanical keyboards, most of which requires this thing, because mechanical keyboards of course have mechanical key switches that we need to solder onto the PCB. Even though I truly believe it's a tool you should have around and it's a great skill to have, it is an extra cost and can be a little daunting. Fortunately for some of you, hot-swap PCBs makes building a mechanical keyboard unbelievably easy. The hardest part is actually knowing what parts go with what. There are keyboard kits that are available with the hot swap option, for example many of the RAMworks keyboards have them, and just a bunch here and there in customs, most of which are pretty pricey and you're usually set on that particular keyboard. But for today we're going to be building a 60% form factor keyboard, which is the most universal in regards to using different parts, meaning that we have more flexibility in how we want it to look, but more importantly, in price. All of the stuff I have today is from KBD fans, which I think is the best place to start, so let's look at the parts I have for this build. First up, we have our plate, which the switches are mounted onto. Then we have our case, along with our feet and screws. And sometimes KBD fans chuck in these little extras. Here's our keycaps, our stabilizers, and our key switches. And finally, what makes this whole thing work, the PCB. This is the DZ60 RGB ANSI V2 hotswap PCB. If you want just the standard 60% layout with the best compatibility, then this is the one for you. They also have other ones available which vary in layout and can include dedicated arrow keys and such, but that'll force you to buy a compatible keyset which may cost more. So these black plastic things are Kale hotswap sockets. This is what the key switch pins will go into and create that connection. For a normal keyboard build, we would have to solder the key switch pins into the PCB. You may come across keyboards that are labelled as hotswappable and come with the Altemu key switches, but those are only compatible with Altemu key switches. The sockets on here are compatible with all MX style key switches, so that includes Cherry MX, Gateron, Kale, Altemu, Drock, Gritech, whatever, but do your research on key switches to try and get the best for you. First step is to install your stabilizers. These are used to support the longer keys and are very important to the quality of the keyboard. So try not to cheap out and get the cheapest ones possible. And I prefer screw-in rather than clip-in so that they don't pop out. The ones I have are GMK screw-in stabs and I got a 60% set, and that includes 4 2U stabs, 1 7U stab, and 1 6.25U stab. U refers to unit, where 1 unit equals 1 normal key. The standard ANSI layout uses a 6.25U spacebar, so we will use that. There's a bunch of mods that you can do to your stabilizers, which are optional, but the one thing you absolutely need to do is lube them. Rattly stabs can completely ruin the feel and sound of a keyboard. Dielectric grease is pretty easy to get, doesn't matter what brand. Another popular alternative is Superlube. You don't need much as you'll see, so it's pretty cheap. If they come assembled, pop out the wires, and then dip the ends into the grease. It's hard doing it on camera, but just don't overload it as it will be sluggish. The stab stems have two holes on one side, and the bottom hole is where you want to stick the wire into. Again, there's other stuff you can do, but lubing is the thing that will make the biggest difference. Now to install them. You'll find holes in the PCB in groups of 4, and you can just imagine where they go. You have the shift keys, spacebar, enter, and backspace. As we are using screw-in stabs, we have to screw them in, and make sure you use the included washers as that prevents any potential shorts. Once everything is installed, make sure it's all good because they're annoying to fix later on when the switches are installed. Next up, we have the plate. This is what the key switches are mounted onto. This is a 60% plate, and you can get these in different materials for different characteristics. So I have brass, which is a little heavier than aluminium. You can also get polycarbonate, carbon fiber, and other plastics. But for a hot swap build, I would recommend a metal plate for stability, as the switches are not soldered in. The switches I have here are Kale Box Jades. One of the best things about building mech is the freedom you have with key switches. You do have to consider that this PCB has RGB backlighting, so if you want that to shine through, you will need switches that have a window, a gap, or just clear housings. Also, when looking at key switches, you'll usually have a choice between 3-pin and 5-pin, which both work absolutely fine. The only difference is that 5-pin have these extra plastic prongs that friction fit into the PCB. Kale switches don't come with those, but when possible, try and get 5-pin for that extra stability, especially for a hot swap build. We're first going to put in a few key switches in the corners and towards the middle, press them in firmly, and they should click into place. And this will provide a platform for us to put the rest of the key switches in. Then line up the pins with the holes in the PCB, and again push firmly until the switches are properly in. Sometimes when you put in a switch, the plate will go down. Just make sure that the plate is parallel with the PCB, and that the key switches are properly in place. The hot swap sockets forces us into having just the one layout, so there's no variety in the bottom row, so you don't need to worry about putting key switches in the wrong place. And you should end up with something like this. All the switches are in as far as they go, they're all level, and the PCB is parallel with the plate. And finally, we get to how we want it to look aesthetically. Here I have the 60% tofu, probably one of the best budget options for an alu case, available in a bunch of colors and has a stunningly simple design. And this is where doing a 60% build in particular becomes very useful. There are a ton of cases available for this form factor. This is a tray mount design, meaning that we have these standoffs on the bottom of the case. And this is the arrangement that you want to find. So this is $88, which is pricey, but good value for what you get. But you can get a really cheap plastic case for 15 bucks or less. There's wooden cases if you want that look. The frosted acrylic ones are really cool, but this PCB does not have RGB underglow, but yeah, you have so much choice, just make sure the standoffs and USB hole are in the correct spots. And last but not least, the keycaps. The common theme with building a standard ANSI 60% is its compatibility. Pretty much any keyset will fit on this. I have this XDA PBT set, which doesn't come with a numpad, and a bunch of other stuff. 50 bucks, so not too pricey, but again, you can definitely buy a much cheaper set. If you're building in another form factor, you will have to have a closer look at keycap compatibility. For example, the right shift key will often be a 1.75U for other compact sizes, which is also included in here. And that's the build done. Plug it in and it's ready to go. If you want to change anything with the layout and customize the different layers, which you may want to do with compact form factors, you will have to download and use QMK, but that's quite a bit to get through, so I'll leave a link in the description about that stuff. So now that it's all built, you can play around and check if it's all working good. I'm pretty lazy, so I'm only doing that now, but you should test before you put it together. If a key isn't working, then that means the key switch probably isn't in properly and a pin is bent. And here's the beauty of hot swap. You don't need to desolder, which is just a massive difference. To remove a key switch, we need to press the two clips inwards. I didn't include one in my order, but you should buy a key switch puller, not to be confused with a keycap puller. Otherwise, you can use like a flathead screwdriver to press the clips in, and then lift the switch up. You can then replace the key switch, or if it's just a bent pin, just straighten it up, and it's good to go. I recommend to order a few extra key switches. This build uses 61 keys, but I ordered 70. Anyway, as said before, these are Kale Box Jades, which are a super clicky switch. Nice and loud as expected. This does cover the sound of the stabilizers, but you can also hear that there was no rattle because I lubed them. Rattly stabs are particularly noticeable in tactile and linear builds as the sound doesn't mask the rattle. I picked this PCB because it's a 60% and fits with a whole lot of stuff. They also have a 65% PCB that fits with a few cases. But when you start looking at more options, it starts getting pretty complicated and there's just so much to cover. There's a bunch of extra custom kits that do have hot swap PCBs, but many are available through group buys and are expensive. Then you might think, why not put this PCB into another keyboard? With a 60% custom, it's definitely very possible, but you have to consider the port placement, the mounting design of the keyboard, and just a whole lot of other stuff. What I wanted to do with this video was to provide the foundations in what you should be looking for, and a lot of that has to do with learning about and working out what is compatible with what. But if you want something that is affordable while also having a bunch of options, do a 60% build. This build was pretty expensive though, being around 300 USD. This is cheap relative to like all other custom mechanical keyboards, but 300 bucks is 300 bucks, and it's a lot of money for something that you can get for 10 bucks. Everything besides the PCB can be downgraded. Get an aluminium plate instead of brass. Get a plastic case instead of the aluminium tofu case and save like 70 bucks. And you can get cheaper keycaps as well. So I hope you can see what's possible. I can't go through all the viable combinations for compatibility, but hopefully this gives you that foundation to build from. I do recommend KBD Fans for beginners as they are a dedicated mechanical keyboard store and they have everything and have decent prices. I'll put a link in the description to a spreadsheet with links for some simple options. And if you have any questions, chuck them down in the comments.